And joining us now is Brad Lamb. He's a board-registered interventionist and the author of How to Change Someone You Love. Good to have you back with us this morning.
Good to be here.
So as we just heard from Hattie, her new attorney, Robert Shapiro, agreed to represent her only if she does her jail time. But there are more reports this morning, reports on TMZ, that she still thinks she's not going to have to go to jail tomorrow. When
you hear that,
what does that tell you about the place where she is right now?
Well, it doesn't surprise me in that somebody gets wiggly, because that's the nature of addiction, is no is yes and yes is no, and you really don't know until the last minute if somebody's really going to follow through with either of those words. So is this place the right place for her right now? I think it's better by far than her being on the street out of clubs at 3 a.m., 4 a.m., 5 a.m. Is it the appropriate place, perfect world, for somebody who's in active addiction? No, it's a very loose program. It's transitional living. It's where someone would go at 60 days
more.
Or 90 days.
Yeah.
It's what we call aftercare. So I was a little surprised by it. But look, there have been times where I've taken a client into the best we can do because you just can't get
it's still better than nothing right now.
Yeah, but I think these next 24 hours are going to be really critical, not only in terms of will she show up, but will she be okay?
So in terms of being okay, going into jail, which all signs point to yes at this point, that she is, in fact, going to jail tomorrow.
Yes.
What's that going to be like for her?
Well, it's going to be a big change, that's for sure. Even from Pickford Lofts, which is where she is now, from a beautiful, well-appointed loft to an 8x10 jail cell. And for the most part, she'll be by herself. This is very important. Linwood is nicotine-free, so there will be no cigarettes. She's a two-pack-a-day smoker, which I was that way when I went into rehab, and that was one of the biggest adjustments going into rehab for many people. I'm saying jail is similar to rehab in that it's a very big change from what she's doing now, which is a zoo-like lifestyle.
Is it ultimately, though, something that could be good for her?
Absolutely. I love the idea of her being safe and slightly sound. And also, once she goes in, the medication that she's on now will not be in her possession. It'll be with a meds nurse. So exactly what they do and how they might change that after a psychosocial, we'll see. But without a doubt, this is a good step.
Right, and that could help set her up for the next step, rehab.
Here's the other big piece. Finally, some consequences to her behavior are coming to the surface. You know, for so long we haven't seen any connection between the behavior, the dangerous behavior, and some real consequences.
So now you're seeing that. We've heard so much about the fact that there's a really strong belief she's addicted to prescription medication. Give me an idea. What is the danger of prescription drugs versus street drugs or alcohol?
It's a great question. And for so many families, it's one that they hear it's from a doctor, this drug or that drug, and they think, oh, my God, the doctor says it's imperative she's on it. But remember, 10 years ago, people were saying that about OxyContin.
Mm-hmm.
And it's addicted an entire generation. The same goes for Adderall and Ritalin. Look, I have clients that crush and snort both those drugs, and they're highly addictive. And if you are a person prone to addiction, you have to be really careful being on any of those drugs.
Right.
I don't even take Ambien. You know, and as a person who's been clean and sober a long time, it's a very slippery slope.
Well, we do wish her the best of luck as she begins this journey. Brad Lamb, great to have your insight with us this morning. Thank you.